Live in high definition.
5 years ago today, a Cherokee County woman disappeared.
Her family later learned that she died on that day, but even now, so many years later, they don't know why. News 4's Mike McCormick is live and local in our Spartanburg newsroom tonight. Mike, what did you find out?
Well, Gabby and Michael, there are different sides to this story. Law enforcement is on one, the coroner is in the middle, and the family is on the other.
She had the most perfect smile.
Lurkeisha Littlejohn stays surrounded by reminders of her sister, Verlisha.
She was a very warm and loving person.
A photo, newspaper clippings, flowers from her funeral, even one of her prized possessions.
It was given to my sister by her dad.
Verlisha Littlejohn was last seen alive on November 28th, 2007.
It's a very, very hard time when you lose someone and they just vanish.
In January 2008, searches of the Broad River led to Verlisha's unclothed body and car in two different places.
The windows were rolled up. How did she get out? She was almost 300 pounds. How do you get out?
The family believes someone killed Verlisha.
The biggest question is why.
But the Cherokee County Sheriff in office at the time closed the case, ruling it an accident or suicide.
The previous sheriff was wrong.
The new sheriff took another look at the file and found no signs of foul play and no reason to reopen the case.
The new sheriff, I need for you to open it back up.
The coroner never made a ruling because of so many unanswered questions. He's leaving the case open.
You could see the compassion in his eyes and in his heart. You could hear it. So I agree with him.
So even after 5 years, the quest for closure continues.
We do forgive whoever done this.
Waiting for proof of what they know in their hearts.
Just come forth and say, hey, I'm sorry.
Verlisha Littlejohn would have turned 30 next month. Mike McCormick, WYFF News 4, live tonight in the Spartanburg newsroom.